Donald Trump once again emerges victorious from an impeachment fiasco, all as three leaders of the left collapse. In this video, we're going to take a look at the latest regarding President Trump's plans for 2022, how the seven Republican rhinos that defected and voted to convict President Trump are already facing a massive backlash, and how three major Democrat leaders have all imploded in the span of just a week. You're not going to want to miss this. Greetings, everyone. Dr. Steve here with you. Wonderful to be with you as always. We're here to give you each and every day conservative hope in the midst of these turbulent times, helping you to think better so you can feel better. So if you haven't already done so, you know what to do. Make sure to smack that bell and subscribe button. We'd love to have you as a regular part of this channel. For you Rumble fans out there, make sure to subscribe to our brand new Rumble channel by clicking on the link below. We're heading upwards of about 100,000 subs there. And for you podcast fans, make sure to click on the link below and sign up for our various podcast platforms as well. We're now one of the top 20 podcasts in the nation for political commentary. With your help, we're going to reach number one. And before we dive in here, we have a special President's Day sale for all of you. Just for today, you can now get your own Nationalist Populist book bundle at a 40% discount. That's right, you can get five of my best books on the rise of nationalist populism all over the world at a super discount. So we're talking my new nationalism, we're talking the return of Christendom, we're talking President Trump and our post-secular future, the triumph of tradition, and uprising on the yellow vest populist revolt. And you can get all of these just by clicking on the link below in the pinned comment section, and you're getting a coupon for 40% off all five books. And you even have the option of getting some really cool swag like our Turley Talks tumblers here. So don't wait. This is just for President's Day. It's our President's Day special. It's good only for today, February 15th. So click on the link below, get 40% off your own Nationalist Populist book bundle today. All right, gang, let's dive right in here. Donald Trump is beginning this week victorious as he once again stomps a pathetic impeachment circus, as I'm sure you all know by now. Trump was acquitted a second time in a year, the Democrats having failed once again to get rid of Trump. They even had some more help from a bunch of feckless rhino Republicans who demonstrated themselves to no longer be fit for purpose. Seven Republican senators voted to convict Trump over the weekend, and CNBC is reporting that they are all facing a massive backlash back in their respective home states. But hey, you know, you guys in Louisiana, North Carolina, and Utah, you know, you get what you vote for. If you're going to keep sending us a bunch of rhino neocons to D.C., if you're going to continue to feed the swamp with swamp creatures like Ben Sassy Pants, who writes books decrying the coarsening of our culture and complaining about our current state of affairs, but who offers literally nothing concrete to resolve it. I mean, Sass is your typical milquetoast conservative. All he does is diagnose problems that we can all see with our own eyes. We certainly don't need him to point out anything to us. We all see it. All he does is point out that, you know, this whole pathetic political class establishment Republican Party, all they do is diagnose, but they can't fix a damn thing. They are useless and they are no longer fit for purpose. And it looks like none other than Senator Lindsey Graham is recognizing that. He said that Trump is already positioning himself to help the GOP destroy the Democrats in 2022, which is being helped by the election reform that's going on in at least five of the contested states from this past November. It's growing increasingly clear that the 5% of Republicans who don't want anything to do with Trump had better start looking for another line of work. And speaking of another line of work, in the shadow of Trump's second impeachment victory in a row, I came across a great piece detailing how leftist leadership in the Democratic Party is beginning to implode. National Review had a very good piece out entitled "The Icons of the Left Collapse." And in it, the author Jim Garrity lists out three giants among the Democrats that have fallen in just the past week: New York Governor Andrew Cuomo, California Governor Gavin Newsom, and the vile anti-Trump group of Republicans known as the Lincoln Project. All three have collapsed over the past few days, which of course is some very bad news for the Democrats. Let's start with Gavin Newsom, who's now officially facing a recall petition. It is now official. Organizers collected the required 1.5 million signatures to force a recall vote against Newsom. Newsom, of course, was humiliated when he was caught attending a birthday party that violated his own COVID-19 restrictions. At least part of the party was clearly held indoors, right? The photographs to prove it, without masks, far beyond the gathering limit of three households together at the same time. It was a political disaster, of course. It continues to be. And with the latest round of extreme COVID restrictions, it just seems it's blowing the roof off of Newsom's administration. Moreover, Newsom has presided over the continued collapse of California, according to the U.S. Census, every year for the past 15 years. An average number of 100,000 Californians leave the state as over against those who move in, and Newsom has only exacerbated the problem. In addition to the recall petition, a number of businesses are refusing to shut down and comply with the current lockdown. And so we're seeing nothing less really than a full-blown rebellion against this leftist California governor who is considered a rising star in the Democrat Party and definitely a future presidential candidate. Well, those aspirations appear to be over. And not just for Gruesome Newsom, but also for New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. Remember, Cuomo was heralded by the mainstream Marxist media as a true leader of the nation during the advent of the COVID crisis. You couldn't go a day without hearing the left-wing activists disguised as journalists in the mainstream media breathlessly imagining him as their next and future president. Well, that ain't happening either. More and more New York lawmakers are calling for Governor Cuomo's removal from office after the latest bombshell, broken ironically by the New York Times, believe it or not, that Cuomo's State Department of Health deliberately underreported COVID-19 deaths in nursing homes by as much as 50%. Newly leaked conversation, Cuomo's top aide admitted that data was withheld on nursing homes where more than 10,000 New Yorkers died during the pandemic. And so even the New York Times is reporting that this indeed appears to be a very significant cover-up on the scope of the death toll in New York nursing homes. And so Cuomo is doing, he's doing everything he possibly can to quell the political fallout from this. But as we argued on another video a few weeks back when this story first broke, we argued here that Cuomo's politically dead. As a result of this, there was no way he was going to be able to squirm his way out of this one. And that's being confirmed by the calls for his removal from office that are beginning to well up as we speak. New York legislators are calling to line up. They're lining up to get Cuomo booted from office. Even Senator Rand Paul from Kentucky is calling for Cuomo's removal. And as of today, even CNN was leading the pro-Andrew Cuomo fawning last year during the initial COVID lockdowns. Even CNN is having to report that there are growing calls for Cuomo's impeachment. So it looks like Andrew Cuomo, the darling of the political left, is now officially politically dead. And you know who else is politically dead? That vile Lincoln Project, that group of hateful so-called Republicans, that's who. But before we get into that, make sure to click on the link below and down your own alt-tech directory guide, which we call the New Conservative Survival Guide to Big Tech Censorship. It is absolutely free for you as an ebook download. It is a guide that is going to give you all the alternative social media sites that are popping up all over the place that you can go to for all your favorite independent content creators, but of course without any of the censorship that we're being subjected to by big tech. It's also going to give you insights into what scholars are calling, get this, an emerging post-Google age. It's absolutely free as an ebook download. That's yours by simply clicking on the link below. So do not let big tech censors get in the way of your favorite content creators. Click on that link below and enjoy your survival guide to big tech censorship today. All right, gang. So you probably remember, we did a video on this. Do you remember Rick Wilson, right? Who's one of the leaders of this now defunct organization, the Lincoln Project, how he was on Don Lemon's show that nobody watches on CNN, and he called the deplorables, the MAGA crowd, Trump's base, he called them, quote, the credulous boomer rube demo that backs Donald Trump, right? That's what you and I are to this guy. We're the credulous boomer rube demo. And Wilson kept going. He actually broke into a Southern accent, a bad one, by the way, mimicking his parody of a Trump supporter. Donald Trump's the smart one, and y'all elitists are dumb. So the good news is that nobody actually watched this as it was happening, this flagrant insult. But that'll give you a sense of who was running this vile organization called the Lincoln Project that was dedicated to targeting and defeating Republicans. Well, as it turns out, one of their founders, John Weaver, is being accused by nearly 24 young men and boys as sexually inappropriate harassment. And the moment the story broke, Rick Wilson and Kellyanne Conway's husband, you know, again, is another vile never-Trumper. They did everything they possibly could to spin their way out of any association with Weaver, but it was all for naught. As it turns out, that was just the tip of the iceberg. A number of outlets are reporting that of the tens of millions of dollars that the Lincoln Project raised, only a small portion actually went to defeating candidates. So it's increasingly looking like there were plenty of other shenanigans going on among the Lincoln Project founders as well. So that organization has now imploded, and we'll have to see what comes of the founders. So there you are, three major Democrats, all imploding in just a matter of a few weeks. President Trump has been acquitted yet again, and while he's ready to help the MAGA movement dominate 2022 and beyond, the Democrats have been defeated yet again, and in the process, three of their brightest stars just faded out. Not a good week to be a Democrat. Now, before you go, make sure to like this video, comment down below, and definitely subscribe to my channel. And you definitely want to check out my latest video I just uploaded. It was our most recent live stream just last night on Trump's impeachment victory and his 2022 and 2024 plans. You're not going to want to miss it. So make sure to click on the link, and I will see you over there. God bless.